Welcome to the 2022 first robotics competition kickoff for Rapid React, presented by the Boeing Company. Coming to you live. That's right, we are live from the home of FIRST in Manchester, New Hampshire. I'm Blair from FIRST, and I know that you are as excited as we are here in New Hampshire to get back on the field at this season's competitions. Today's kickoff is it's a welcome step towards resuming in-person play, and a big thanks to kickoff sponsor Ford for helping us launch the 2022 season. Now, while we had all hoped the COVID pandemic would be behind us by now, unfortunately, it continues to be a part of our daily lives. So today, we're producing the kickoff with safety foremost in mind, following guidance from health and science experts, as well as local regulations, vaccine requirements, masking except when we're on camera, and social distancing is happening at all times. All of those are being followed. Every precaution has been taken to keep us safe and to set an example of what a live event can look like this season in the world of COVID. Thank you for joining us at one of the 132 local kickoffs taking place right now around the world. Over 3,200 teams are eager to take on this year's challenge, and we'll be checking in with some of them a bit later in the show. Now this season, First Forward, presented by Qualcomm, challenges FIRST teams to look to the future of transportation, taking lessons from the past and evolving transportation modes into something better for the planet and its inhabitants. As we imagine and discover future technologies and industries, Qualcomm and FIRST together are positioned to inspire and engage future leaders and innovators. Qualcomm engineers understand that innovative engineering, creative thinking, and teamwork lay the foundation for future discovery. Together, we can propel the next evolution of transportation on this planet and beyond. Together, we have the power to build a path forward and invent the future of transportation. Today's students will be the drivers of tomorrow's breakthroughs. It starts here with you. A big thanks to Qualcomm for looking ahead and for investing in the future. We're proud to partner with them for the First Forward season and grateful for their continued support over the years. There are many local kickoffs going on around the world, as I said. Some are in person and some are virtual. Let's start the show with a check-in at a local kickoff with some hopefully excited teams down in Mexico. Hello, Laguna, the Laguna Regional. Hello, Hector.
Hello there, Blair.
They are excited. Let's see. Are those teams excited at all behind you? They're clapping a little bit.
I don't know. Are we excited, Laguna?
Oh, yes. There's a couple of rooms you have full of people there. Now, are you ready for the season? Are you ready to see what the game is?
You're sure, but don't hit it for me. Are we excited, teams?
And now we hear you. Well, thanks for sharing a local kickoff with us. Thanks for excitement. How many of those teams will we see at the championship?
How many teams? All of you?
Two, okay.
They're all going.
Okay, we hope to see you all at the championship. Hey, good luck in the season this year, and thanks for sharing your local kickoff with us.
Thank you. Enjoy the challenge, and buena suerte a todos.
Buena suerte a todos. Good luck to everybody. Now we check in with the Toluca Mexico Regional. We have Manuel and Gabriela. Happy kickoff. Are you ready for the season? Hey, they unmuted. That's awesome. This whole Zoom thing. Hello, Gabriela. Hello, Manuel. This is like if you're listening, if you're calling in a talk show radio, turn off your radio because there's a delay. Yeah, that's what this is. Oh, that's a heck of a delay. Let's just wave. Let's show some excitement. Raise up. Show some excitement. There it is. Happy kickoff. Muchas gracias, adios. Enjoy the kickoff and good luck this season. It's fantastic to see all that passionate kickoff energy there in Mexico, even if it was a little delayed. Now this season, as we rethink the future of transportation and explore new exciting technologies like unmanned delivery vehicles and personal space flights, who better to step up as a presenting sponsor of Rapid React than the Boeing Company? Boeing has been at the leading edge of the transportation space for decades with aircraft, helicopters, rockets, spacecraft. And here's a word from their chief technology officer, who is also a first volunteer and a big believer in what we do.
Hello, FIRST Robotics competition teams, and welcome to Rapid React, presented by Boeing. I'm Naveed Hussain, Chief Technology Officer at Boeing, and former FIRST Robotics competition judge. As a FIRST strategic partner for more than 10 years, Boeing continues to be inspired by FIRST participants, and we're thrilled to be part of the 2022 FIRST Robotics competition season. The skills you are developing today will be the skills you'll use to innovate a better tomorrow. And I've seen it firsthand. I've had the chance to meet many of you in the arena and see your teams in action, competing, creating, and building the confidence to go further. At Boeing, we know you are the generation that will propel us forward. People who were in your footsteps not long ago are now at Boeing, charting the way ahead. Take, for example, our joint venture with Kitty Hawk, a company called Whisk. At this very moment, the Whisk team is working to deliver all-electric, fully autonomous aerial vehicles for passengers and cargo. Cora, the name of this two-passenger eVTOL air taxi, has already logged more than 1,500 test flights. And our Eco Demonstrator program, launched in 2012, is taking promising technologies out of the lab and testing them in the air to solve real-world challenges. In this year's program, all test flights use a blend of conventional and sustainable aviation fuel for cleaner flying. How will you be part of the future of transportation? All of us at Boeing wish you a safe and fun competition season as your innovation, creativity, and ingenuity continue to propel you forward.
We are excited to partner with Boeing for the Rapid React season. Thank you, Boeing. Achieving new heights has never been more within our reach. Now, we're also fortunate to have another strong partner that's been imagining the future for a long time, and in a galaxy not that far away. The Walt Disney Company. They believe that as diverse creators, thinkers, and leaders, you, FIRST students, hold the power to create a future that is more equitable and inclusive for generations to come. And that's why we're joining forces with Disney and Lucasfilm once again to demonstrate how using your FIRST skills beyond gameplay for good. To tell you more about our new initiative, here are a few of your fans from Star Wars.
Hello, FIRST teams. More than ever before, we need ambitious, creative, and optimistic minds to solve the world's greatest challenges.
Through the power of science, technology, engineering, and math, today's students can face these challenges and create the futures they imagine, both for themselves and their communities.
You did it!
Together, FIRST, Disney, and Lucasfilm are on a mission to spotlight how young people are using STEM to create a more equitable and inclusive world so everyone has the opportunity to thrive.
And today, we are very excited to announce our new initiative, Build the Future, powered by Star Wars Force for Change.
And here's where you come in. As future technologists, engineers, and innovators, you can harness the power to create a world that is better for future generations. As we confront increasingly complex challenges, from health and hunger to climate and clean water, we need creative, groundbreaking ideas. Your ideas.
How will you use your tools and skills to create a world that pushes boundaries and addresses critical issues to help pave the way so everyone belongs? The knowledge you gain within STEM is preparing you for a journey like no other, where you can use your technical know-how and creativity to change the world.
We want to hear how you and your teammates are using STEM skills beyond gameplay to be forces for good in your local communities.
Submit your story for the chance to be featured by Disney and Lucasfilm in our upcoming initiative.
Visit the link below for more information on how to participate.
We can't wait to hear your stories of hope and innovation and share them with the world through Build the Future, powered by Star Wars Force for Change. May the Force be with you.
May the Force be with you.
May the Force be with you.
So, how are you being a force for change in your community? We want to hear from you. Share your team's story for the chance to be featured in Build the Future, powered by Star Wars Force for Change. Visit our Build the Future webpage to view and share stories from the First Community. Now, speaking of stories, we started building excitement for the season months ago with a 4-episode teaser series where we planted game hints as a kit of parts tote and a 2022 game element journeyed around the world. Here's a brief recap of that journey, including the 4 game hints. One of those stops was in Turkey, so let's check in with one of their local kickoffs. Hello, Turkey!
Hi, Blair!
How are you? Are you excited for kickoff?
We are great. All these people are great in here. Look how excited they are!
Awesome! Look at them all! That's great! Turkey keeps growing more and more teams every year. You have a new regional this year. That's exciting. You just saw the teasers. Well, you saw a recap of the teasers. So I want you to guess, what do you think this year's game will be, Besta?
We think it would be the water game, finally.
Finally the water game. Well,
yeah.
There is a pool really close to me right now. So maybe it would be the water game. We'll find out in a little bit. Now, you're doing like workshops all day too, right?
Yeah, we did the project workshop, the safety workshop, and we also organize an esports tournament.
Wow, esports, safety, that's great. Do you really want to find out what the game is? It sounds like you're busy enough.
No, we're looking forward to see the team.
Okay, well, we'll see the challenge in a little bit. Thanks for checking in. Have a great season and enjoy the kickoff.
Lots of love from Turkey. Bye.
Thank you so much. They are great. Okay, now the last I checked, the Kit of Parts tote was almost back here to New Hampshire, but it had stopped at kickoff sponsor Ford's world headquarters in Detroit, Michigan. Let's see what a couple of First alums, now Ford engineers, are up to with that tote.
Good. How are you?
Doing really well. It's good to see you. I haven't seen you in a while. What are you doing with the First Kit of Parts?
Yeah, so we're actually working on trying to get this out to New Hampshire. The tote's been around the world at this point, and we're looking at how we can best get it out to New Hampshire for the 2022 First Kickoff.
Wow, that's awesome. I'm really excited for the game this year.
Yeah.
What were you doing with it?
So we've actually had it out at the U of M Ford Robotics building out in Ann Arbor for the past week, testing out the new game parts for the 2022 kickoff event. Wow, I've heard really good things about happening at the Robotics Center out there. What have you been working on?
So Ford has been really invested in working on the areas of last mile delivery using robots such as the Digit bipedal platform to test out delivering packages from your AV out to the front door, as well as robotics in the areas of manufacturing to make a really great factory of tomorrow.
Wow, that's really interesting that Ford's so involved in that.
Yeah, exactly. What about you? What have you been working on here?
Yeah, so I'm just here today doing some research, but typically I work in the new wind tunnel facility we just started out down in Dearborn. I work a lot with the battery electric vehicles. What's really important in battery electric vehicles is the range, and one of the biggest parts of that is aerodynamics. So what I do in the wind tunnel is I test to see different ways that we can lessen aerodynamic drag and improve efficiencies in our vehicles for our customers.
That's really great. So we're working on kind of the two key areas of Ford's efforts to make a more sustainable, technology-centric world.
Exactly, and I really feel like everything we did at FIRST is exactly what led us here.
Definitely. So I think, like, with my time in FIRST, starting out as a small middle schooler in FIRST LEGO League and then moving into robotics throughout high school and into college, I think FIRST was able to get a lot of those key components of kind of problem solving, figuring out what the main idea that you need to solve for is, and then kind of move toward a solution.
I wouldn't be an engineer without FIRST. My mentor pushed me to get involved in engineering and join the team when I was in 11th grade, and it was so wonderful. And I really feel like what I do in the wind tunnel is exactly what we did during competitions and during the build season. Everything we do here at Ford really relates back to what we did at FIRST.
Yeah, definitely. So I think I've kept this tote a little too long, and I think I actually need to get it out to New Hampshire really quickly for the 2022 kickoff. I've been spending a little too much time playing with the game pieces. Do you have any idea how I can get it out there?
I think I might.
I wonder what they're thinking and how they get the tote back to us. We can't unveil this year's challenge without it. Hurry up! Now, Ford is working on some super interesting projects, creating groundbreaking technology. Once a car company and now a technology company, Ford is certainly looking to you and looking to the future. Now, after seeing those alumni, we want to remind you about some great benefits for FIRST participants and alumni. There are lots of tools and opportunities for you to apply the skills you've gained from being on a FIRST team. We have career panels, scholarships, college fairs, and the FIRST Alumni Handbook to help make sense of it all. Check out our alumni website. It's all there. And teams, if you're looking for some additional mentor support, the FIRST Mentor Network, sponsored by NI, has over 500 mentors ready and willing to share their skills and talents to assist your team. Create a team profile and get connected today. Speaking of mentors, we want to recognize over two decades of remarkable effort, spirit, and passion that Woody Flowers generously gave to help make FIRST such a success. His lasting legacy will surely be his creation and expectation of gracious professionalism.
And FIRST, we do our best work while helping others and treating folks with respect and kindness.
If you compete such that if your grandmother saw everything that you did on a national television program, she would be very proud, then that'll be okay.
Gracious is mostly about feelings, both yours and those of others. Professionalism is mostly about knowledge and its application for good. Combining the two is important, so learn everything you can and experience helping others as often as you can. Rational self-esteem is a big deal, and it is a likely outcome from practicing gracious professionalism while busting your chops in FIRST. So use your FIRST experiences well. They will serve you well. Gracious professionals tend to be satisfied, happy people. So, again, both gracious and professionalism are essential to the kind of meaningful life we all want to live.
We are indebted to Woody for creating this ethos of FIRST and ask that you continue to maintain a high standard of gracious professionalism, honoring his legacy with an even stronger resolution to keep gracious professionalism as part of everything that you do. Do it, and you'll make Woody and your grandmother proud. And now it's time to meet a new employee at FIRST. Oh, he's not just any employee. He's the new FIRST CEO. To introduce Chris Moore to the FIRST community, please welcome FIRST Robotics Competition Team member Vanessa from Team 8708.
Thanks, Blair, and welcome to FIRST, Chris.
Thank you. It's so nice to meet you, Vanessa, and it's just so great to be here experiencing my first major kickoff of FIRST, and this is just amazing. And I'm so in awe of all of the kids, all the young people that I just watched on video.
Yeah, it's a big day in the FIRST world. So, Chris, please tell us a little bit about yourself and how you became the CEO of FIRST.
Well, so I just finished what I believe is week 7 or 8 as the CEO of FIRST, and it's been like drinking from a fire hose, but in a good way. I've truly enjoyed spending time getting to know the staff of FIRST, the members of our board of directors, members of the FIRST community, spending time with our founder, Dean Kamen. And so a little bit about me. I've spent the past decade leading youth sport organizations, organizations that administer programs and competitions and that work to change the culture of youth sports by being a catalyst for positive youth sports culture and communities all across the country. And in short, these were all youth development organizations that empowered youth to take an active part in their own health and well-being. And so when I learned of the opportunity at FIRST and the parallel to youth sports and the opportunity to build meaningful competitions and work with young people to inspire them to become leaders, coupled with the need of the organization to grow and scale, I knew that it was the perfect match, and so I'm excited to be here.
We're excited to have you here. And what do you plan to bring to FIRST from the sports world?
That's an interesting question, Vanessa. So here's what I'd say in response. My experience working in youth sports, coaching youth baseball, mentoring young people, working with teams, coaches, volunteers, delivery partners, administrators, high energy athletes, building recreational and competitive programs and making sports accessible to and inclusive for all kids, regardless of their socioeconomic status, gender, age, income, or zip code. All these things, I believe, have uniquely prepared me to take on this important role at FIRST and lead the organization into the future. But apart from just the what I call the X's and O's of and the direct experience of working for youth sport organizations, I also bring years of experience in business development, in marketing, sponsorship development. And so working with an amazing team at FIRST, I'm really confident that I can draw upon these experiences and to help accelerate our growth into the future.
And I know you're new, but where do you see FIRST in 10 years?
Well, of course, I don't have a crystal ball, but we at FIRST, as you know, we have an amazing lineup of programs, innovative programs and competitions that vary by age and focus area, including the FIRST Lego League, FIRST Tech Challenge, and FIRST Robotics Competition. And so over the next 10 years, I guess what I'd say is I would expect that we're going to optimize those programs, expand our program offerings, reaching even more young people, more participants, and delivering a world-class event experience, both domestically and internationally. We're going to be more intentional about our relevancy, our awareness, value proposition, and outreach to youth and underserved and underrepresented communities. And over the next 10 years, I would say that we're going to continue to deliver on the mission of FIRST, inspiring young people through STEM to become leaders, entrepreneurs, problem solvers, innovators, and to help them really live their best life stories, helping them develop into high-achieving adults along the way. And so that's what I would expect. And then I would say, finally, we're going to unlock that next growth frontier for FIRST, enhancing and deepening our partnerships not only with commercial organizations like sponsors, but nonprofits, government agencies, foundations, individual donors, and such. And we're going to really, you know, forge closer partnerships with our program delivery partners as well. So here at FIRST, as you know, we've created a sport that's as exciting as any other sport. But the difference in our sport from other sports is that literally every kid can make it to the pros here at FIRST. And we're going to continue to make that, you know, story a reality for FIRST participants. And to be clear, we're not, you know, a science fair. We're not a science experiment. And we're not merely in the business of, you know, building robots. As Dean often says, we're not using, we're not using kids to build robots. We're using robots to build kids. And I would expect that over the next 10 years, we're going to continue to tell that story and to help build the organization from there. So let me just turn the tables on you, Vanessa, and ask you, what's your 10-year plan? What do you hope to do over the next 10 years?
Wow, over the next 10 years, I plan to become an engineer and, going by my team's motto, making some pretty okay stuff.
Sounds like a wonderful plan to me.
And, of course, I'll be mentoring a FIRST team.
That sounds like a wonderful plan. I just want to thank you for this interview. I really appreciate appreciate everything you do for FIRST. It was great to meet you. I want to say also thanks so much to all of the kids and all of the teams who make up the FIRST community.
Thanks, Chris. Oh, and one last thing. While you may be a FIRST rookie, I'm an 11-year veteran. So if you want a veteran's perspective, feel free to reach out.
I might just do that. Thanks so much for that offer. Best of luck to you and your career. Really appreciate it. And again, thanks to all the wonderful teams that make up the FIRST community.
Thanks, Chris. Now back to you, Blair.
Thank you, Vanessa and Chris. And now let's check in again at Ford and see how Laura and Meghna plan to get our kit of parts tote back here so we can unveil the game.
So this is Meghna. She is a FIRST alum, and now she works out for Ford at the U of M Robotics Center.
Oh, it's so nice to meet you, Meghna.
Really nice to meet you too, Linda.
I got your text, and I saw your red Mach-E, so I parked right next to it, and I brought the all-electric F-150 Lightning. This will get you 0 to 60 in mid 4 seconds, so definitely get you there fast. Not only is it the quickest F-150 ever, it's also packed with innovation and technology. So for example, with Blue Cruise, it'll let you go hands-free on the highway for a lot of the way there. So hopefully that'll make your ride a lot smoother. A truck like this doesn't build itself, right? So we're so excited to be able to support FIRST Robotics because science, math, technology, and engineering is so important to getting this truck out on the road. So we're really excited to be able to help you guys out with this FIRST tote to get it to New Hampshire. So, ready to go?
Yeah, let's load it up.
Okay, great.
Wow, Linda, this is huge.
Yeah, with 400 liters and 400 pounds of payload, it's definitely gonna be able to get this tote there, no problem.
Awesome, I bet she'll fit right in.
Just so you know, we also have tons of outlets right here and around the truck, so if you ever need some electricity, it's good to go.
Thank you so much, Linda.
You're very welcome. Thanks. Good luck, guys.
Thank you.
Happy kickoff.
Thank you.
Well, it's a good thing that truck is fast because we're getting anxious here. We need that tote, but while we're waiting, let's see what's happening at another local kickoff. This time, let's take a visit in Israel. Shalom.
Shalom, everyone.
Shalom, everyone.
Hello, Corin and Shani. Happy kickoff.
Happy kickoff. We're from Team Sycamore, 5614. Cholon, Israel.
Look at that. They've got graphics. Where are they? There they are. Let's get your audio back. Are they excited? I can see they're excited.
Well, as you can see, we're very excited here.
There it is. We got the audio back. So you saw the game teasers as well, the season teasers. What do you think this game will feature this year?
We think maybe a sorting game or maybe transferring the game elements.
Or maybe we'd see a surprise comeback from one of the previous elements in the former years.
Oh, a little like a little recycle rush again, maybe? Is that what you want? We'll see what the game is. We'll see what the game is in just a second. A recycled game piece. I like it. Sorting, possibly. We'll find out in a few minutes. One more time. How excited are those teams? Can we get a little like pump up in the from your audience there? There you go. Hello, Israel. Wonderful. Have a great season. Enjoy the kickoff and good luck this year. Hope to see some of you at the championship in April. Shalom. All right. They are definitely pumped up. Now, let's have another student voice to help with our next segment. Please welcome Angel from First Robotics Competition Team 166.
Thanks, Blair. It is now my pleasure to introduce the man who started first. Please welcome first founder Dean Kamen.
Greetings, Angel. How are you?
I'm great. It's a pleasure to see you.
Good.
Now, Dean, you've been working with transportation devices for many years now. What got you interested in this field?
It's the intersection of a lot of things. It's science. It's technology. I mean, I fly jet airplanes. They're amazing. I fly helicopters. I built helicopters. I think transportation is so important that we even made this device to help people that can't walk very well be able to do all the things you and I do, to get around. After we built this iBot, we built Segways. So I think transportation is a symbol for freedom. It allows you to go explore. It allows you to have experience. And now in a world where we're worried about the compromise between all of that and preserving the planet, we've got to do even better with our technologies. We've got to make it sustainable transportation.
Yeah, that's fantastic. My generation is really interested in transportation and the planet. What do you think is the next big thing?
One word, electricity. If we can make sustainable electricity available to power all sorts of electric transportation, we will dramatically improve the possibility that the global environment will not be negatively impacted as we all get to do more interesting and exciting transportation and exploration.
Angel and Dean, sorry to interrupt, but I just got word that the tote has arrived from Detroit. So maybe just one more question, and then we can get the tote in here and unveil the game.
Excellent. Dean, in one word, what is a piece of advice that you have for teams with this upcoming challenge while they're brainstorming?
The same one word I give them every year, tenacity, which means stick to it. We're giving you very difficult problems to solve. And we're giving you a very short time to do it in. So there's a lot of excitement, but it brings anxiety. You'll fail. You'll fail a lot. You're trying to do new and different things. But each time you fail, if you pick yourself up, you stick to it, you get going, in the end, you'll have a great experience. You'll learn a lot. And tenacity is what it takes to eventually succeed when you're trying to solve very difficult problems.
Great. Thank you, Angel and Dean. Great advice, Dean. Tenacity. You've got it. And here's Kate from the Kit of Parts team and our game design team, finally with the tote. That lightning was fast.
Nice to see you, Kate.
All the way from Ford World headquarters, it is the kickoff kit tote that's been around the world.
We've been expecting you. Thank you. Angel, you think we should open this?
Yes, please.
You take half, I'll take half.
All right.
Okay. You take one, I'll take one. Have a great season, everybody.
Welcome to the 2022 FIRST Robotics Competition. And this year's game, Rapid React, presented by the Boeing Company. Two alliances of three teams each compete to score their cargo balls into the lower hub and the upper hub. They earn additional points if the robots traverse the rungs of their hangar. Robots start each match on one of their tarmacs and may be preloaded with one cargo each. During the first 15 seconds, robots are autonomous. Without guidance from drivers, they leave their tarmac, score preloaded cargo, and collect and score additional cargo. During the remaining 2 minutes and 15 seconds, drivers control their robots. They continue to gather up two cargo at a time and score cargo in the lower and upper hubs. Cargo scored into either hub count towards the cargo bonus. Launch pads protect robots from contact by opponent robots. Robots may use either terminal, where their human players assist the robots with acquiring cargo. As time runs out, robots race to their hangar and traverse as many rungs as possible. The higher a robot gets, the more points it earns. An alliance that reaches a hangar point threshold is rewarded with a ranking point. The alliance that earns the most points wins the match.
Wow, another great game. And now let's go see the only playing field on the planet right now. Rapid React. This field is awesome. And now here's FIRST Robotics Competition Senior Director, Frank Merrick.
Thanks, Blair. We are so excited for this game. We're so excited to finally be back in action, in person, on the field. But you know what? A season like this doesn't come together without a lot of support. So I want to recognize some of our sponsors here. Boeing has been fantastic. A fantastic partner for us, and they even helped with some of the game design work that you see on the field here. Kickoff sponsor Ford has also been a terrific collaborator. Now, us having dedicated sponsors is not a surprise, and we're so happy that they're with us. Something else that is not a surprise is my annual safety reminder. Safety is a top priority for FIRST. Please be safe in everything that you do, off the field and on the field. Off the field, my top safety tip for this season probably isn't a surprise. Get the shot. It's so easy. You'll be doing yourself, your friends, your family, and your entire community a favor by getting that shot. On the field, couple tips. You want to be careful when you're around the HAB. When you're walking around the HAB, just keep an eye out on what you're doing there. And when you're at the hangar, please be careful when you are bringing those robots down, because you might want to do some hanging. And if you're going to do some hanging, you want to be able to bring your robots down safely. Now, as Blair said, this is the only field in the world that is currently set up. You might not be able to experience this directly until you get to your event. However, we've got the playing field page, which is going to show you, have a number of virtual tools to help you experience the field indirectly. And among those tools, I had to write them down here because there's no way I was going to remember them. You've got your field drawings, you got your CAD models, you got your VR experiences, you've got your field tour videos, and you got your field photo album. Go check those out. It'll help you strategize and check out sight lines and all the kind of stuff that you need to do to be ready to play this game and play it well. Finally, I just want to say good luck, all the teams. Special shout out to the 170 rookies that we have this year. Stay safe, have fun, and I'll see you at the competitions.
Great. Thank you, Frank. On this field, we know you're going to have a lot of questions, so put them in the Twitch chat, and after we explore the field a little bit, we'll get to your questions a little bit later. We will also have our field tour videos available on YouTube via our website. We'll show those at the end of the show as well. But we'll first start with a tour of the field. Now, standing at the hub is Kate Pilot from the game design team. Kate, tell us about the hub.
Thank you so much, Blair. Happy kickoff, everybody, and welcome to the hub. It is the two goals in Rapid React. They are shared between the red and blue alliances. We have the upper hub for more points, the lower hub for some points. They both have agitators that spin inside the goal that helps prevent those cargo balls from getting stuck and also helps them escort them to the exits. There are four exits at the bottom of each goal, up here, down here, that direct balls out and away from the hub. The other thing to note, right, we can see some of that happening behind me now. The other thing to note is that the lower hub has a chain, which helps kind of deaden those shots and retain most of the shots, but occasionally a cargo ball could bounce off of it and back out of the hub and not score. So just a heads up on that. I know that it looks big, it looks complicated, but it was designed so that teams can kind of mock up a simple version at home pretty quickly and pretty inexpensively. So if you have more questions about it, please put them in the Twitch chat. We can come back here later if you like. Blair, what's next?
Thank you, Kate. Great job. That's the hub. Now let's go explore the terminal with Derek from the game design team. Derek.
Thank you, Blair. The terminal is where humans assist their robots. So the robots can feed cargo to the humans, and then humans feed cargo back to the robots at a height that is slightly above the edge of the low hub. This is especially important for robots without floor pickup. Human players should be careful as they pick up their cargo. We don't want to see anyone bump their heads on the terminal. This station, like the hub, is shared between the alliances. This means that both alliances can use both of the terminals. Human players shall be wearing aprons that will help referees and spectators identify whether they're part of the red or the blue alliance. There are rules making sure that human players don't mess around with their opponent's cargo. However, we didn't want to write a bunch of rules to make sure that a human player was behaving next to their opponent. We just need to practice some gracious professionalism and make Woody proud. But that's not all. During autonomous, the human player closest to their driver station can attempt shots. So we know you want to see what that shot looks like. So today, Ted is here to give us a demonstration.
Derek, thank you for that tour of the hub, the terminal. Ted, keep practicing in the driveway. What Ted just showed you is that ain't easy. That's a tough shot. So good luck during autonomous, human players. We've got one more field element to explore, and then we will release the game manual code, and then we'll come back here on the field and answer your questions. So keep filling up that chat with questions for us. We'll get to them in about 2 minutes. All right, Kate, you're at the hangar. What is that all about?
I am. Welcome to the hangar. There are two hangars, one red, one blue. This is the blue hangar. And this is where a lot of robots are going to head at the end of the match to get some of those extra bonus points. The hangar is a lot like monkey bars, except instead of the bars being horizontal at the same height, the bars ascend in height, with the highest rung being the traversal rung, up above me here. I don't know if you can see that. And the one thing that I do want to point out about the hangar is this is the only rung that could actually rotate a little bit, so it's not fixed in place. So if you are going for that rung, know that it's possible that it spins a little bit. And then the last feature that I think is important to highlight is a little subtle, but down here on the floor, just below the mid rung, is a black strip of tape, which teams can use to help kind of align their robot with this rung if it's helpful to have kind of that ground reference. So again, put your questions in the chat. We can come back here later if you like.
All right, great looking field. Great job for our game design team. They certainly have given you a challenge this season. Now remember, There are 4 field tour videos. We'll show them at the end of the show. But right now, we need to release the code to the game manual. We'll release that, have a little light show on the field here for 10 seconds, and then get back to your chat questions. So get those questions in. Release the code. All right, we will leave the game manual code up. It's now open. All the answers in there are in there. You'll hear it over and over. Read the manual, read the manual, read the manual. We've got some questions coming in. Our first one is from Plarian Likes Boba. And the question is, how many cargo can a robot carry? Kate?
Yeah, so we have cargo here. Robots can start with up to 1 in their robot at the start of the match, and then during the match, they can hold up to 2, and it doesn't matter which color. Okay. But read the manual for details.
Thank you. Did you say read the manual?
I did.
I think I heard you say that. Our next question is from Bob Zinkoff, and he would like to see a demo of the terminal, the cargo going in and out of the terminal. So maybe Kate and Derek, you could both do that?
Absolutely. So the idea is for a robot without floor pickup, they can use this to come over, bring some cargo over to their human player, who can then retrieve it, return it to the robot at a height that's convenient and planned that it's conveniently the same height as the top of the lower hub.
All right. The next question, very interesting. Wilster9000 wants to know, Kate, do you have to climb the rungs in order?
Ah, that is a good question. And this is another one where I'm going to say my typical read the manual. But the idea is that a robot can reach this rung. A robot can reach the mid rung. But the robot height restricts access to the high and the traversal rung. And so it's up to a team to figure out how to get there.
All right, we've got another question from Ace2860. They want to know, is there any reflective tape on the field? Derek?
There is. Along the upper edge of the upper hub, there is a ring of polycarbonate with 5-inch strips of retroreflective material.
All right. Our next is just, we've had a few requests to see what it looks like from each behind each driver station. So Kate, maybe you could take Adam on the our handheld camera guy.
So Adam and I are gonna head back behind the Alliance station. And while we're traveling, I just wanna say that I wanna remind everybody that there are great tools on the FIRST website, on the playing field page. There's VR tools, there's CAD models, there's simulations that can also help you see this. If we miss kind of a shot that you really wanna check out, you can use those tools to see exactly what you see. But well, let's give a brief overview. So we're in blue station number 1. And from here, you can see that we are right in front of the hangar. So right in front of us, we have the view is obscured by some of these rungs. But for the most part, we can see Blair. We can see the terminal on the other side of the field. But as soon as we turn to see the middle of the field, we see a lot of problem, right? We see the leg for the hangar is in the way, the hub is there, and so just know that if you're in that spot, that's gonna be a challenge teams are gonna have to work through. If you go a little more to the right, you have an open field view again. Let's come over here into the player station 2 in the middle of the Alliance wall. So here you have a pretty good view of your hangar. You can see the shadow line that helps you line up your robot with that mid rung. You also have a really great view of the hub, but unfortunately, the view behind the hub is pretty obscure. You can see Blair back there, but you know that if something is down on the floor or low, that's gonna be hard to see through that structure, so just be aware of that. You can see the terminal pretty clearly, and you can see the red hangar pretty clearly as well. Finally, we're in station number 3. Now you have a great view of the red hangar. You have a great view, you still have your great view of the hub. You can see your hangar, the blue hangar from here, but it might be a little bit harder if there are maybe robots in the way or it's congested over there. But then you still have kind of this great center view of the hub, but really hard to see past it, and maybe a little bit more trouble connecting up and lining up with the terminal on the far side of the field if you're trying to drive from this station. But again, check out those tools online. Hopefully that'll help make it really clear.
Great. All right. Thank you so much for that tour. While you're there, Adam, we're going to continue going. We've got a question from Princess Fifi, who wants to know, can a cargo get thrown between the guard and the chute on the terminal, Derek?
That's a great question. The cargo is fairly tight in this hood area, so it's unlikely that a team can throw it through. As you can see, if I push it, it kind of gets stuck. So really, teams are just supposed to roll it down to their robots.
All right, the cargo's getting a lot of questions. So our next one is from Z Cow Plays, who wants to talk a little bit more about the cargo, maybe show how bouncy it is. There you go. Kate, that's for you.
Yeah, sure, no problem. So I've got red and blue, they're the same. The seams are dyed to match the Alliance color. And so if we drop it, I'm just a little taller than 5 feet. So if we drop it from kind of my head height, you can see kind of how bouncy they are. Hopefully that answers some of the dynamic questions, but you have some in your tote, so you can try this out yourself. You can see in the manual that we kind of describe how it's inflated to the size and to, I'll say, the bounciness, the coefficient of restitution, if you will, kind of how much it bounces when it's dropped. So hopefully that'll help you inform what to expect on the field.
A coefficient of bounce, love it.
Coefficient of bounce.
This question is from Midnight Rose Zero. Kate, you've got a cargo. How many cargo can be shot during autonomous period? Can the human player shoot? How many cargo can they shoot?
How many cargo can the human player shoot during the autonomous period? There is no limit. Each terminal starts with one readily available for that human player to work with. There's another cargo stage just outside the terminal, and so in order for the human player to have access to that, they'll need some robot help, an assist, if you will. And then if the robot can bring over additional cargo for that human player to shoot during autonomous, they may do so. There's no limit, there's no cap.
Great. Derek, where do robots start at the beginning of the match?
The robots start in what we call the tarmac, which there are two tarmacs for each color, and you can see the taped area here.
Okay, great. Next question is from Not the Right Dude, who wants to know, where's the safe area for shooting?
So yeah, we mentioned the launch pads in the animation. The launch pad is a plastic piece that's attached to the foot of the front of each hangar. And so as long as a robot is in contact with that plastic piece called the launch pad, they're protected from contact from opponent robots.
Kate, question about the hub. Does the top of the low hub stick out past the fender?
Aha. So come over here. It might be, I don't know if we can get kind of a side shot of this, of the relationship between the top of the lower hub, this ring, and the face of the fender, which is here. The fender does stick out a little bit more than the top of the lower hub.
All right,
you can find Blair.
No, go ahead.
I'm not done.
Go ahead.
But you can find full details, dimensions in the drawings on the playing field page.
All right.
Now I'm done, Blair.
Sorry to interrupt, yes. Never interrupt. Derek, question for you. Our teams have noticed there's a white line in the back of the terminal. What is that for?
So as I mentioned earlier, the only human player in that terminal that is allowed to shoot during autonomous is the one that belongs to the Alliance that is also on this side of the field. The other human player needs to stand behind that white line so that we don't have any unintentional interference with the shots.
Kate, this question comes in from Angel. How do you get the autonomous bonus?
In order to earn a ranking point, an Alliance can shoot 20 cargo in the hub. That earns them a ranking point. However, if they score 5 cargo during autonomous, that threshold drops from 20 to 18.
Okay, Kate, another rule question. Mm-hmm. Sunny167 wants to know, can you pick up the opposing team's cargo during the match?
You may, as long as it doesn't cause you to exceed the cargo control limit, which is in the rules. But yes, robots can carry up to 2 cargo balls at a time, regardless of color, it doesn't matter.
And where do the cargo balls start the match? Kate, yeah, why don't you take that?
Sure. So the cargo balls are staged in a couple different places. So the first one I'll talk about is on, because we were messing around a little bit earlier, these balls are a little askew, but just outside the tarmac, in kind of this perimeter outside the tarmac, I would say a couple feet outside the tarmac, there are 6 of each color staged around in this perimeter. And those robots can access during autonomous, kind of as they leave their tarmacs if they like. Additionally, there's a cargo staged in front of each terminal, kind of centered in front of each terminal, just at the bottom of this ramp that enters the terminal. There's another cargo ball staged in the terminal for easy access by the human player. And then lastly, each robot can start with a cargo in their ball, or I'm sorry, a robot can start with a cargo in themselves. If they decide to forego that and they do not want to start with a cargo ball, then the ball is staged on the opposite side of the field, in between the Alliance wall and this. There's a black strip of tape here to kind of mark where that ball will go. So again, if a red robot decides not to start with a red cargo, it will get staged here over here in front of the blue Alliance wall.
All right. A. Elianon wants to know, I forgot the question already. Does the hub randomize the balls, the cargo? Does the hub randomize the cargo? Derek?
Yes, the hub absolutely randomizes the cargo. There are some agitators on the inside of those hubs that kind of aid in that. In addition, there's some mechanical features on the upper hub that can divert game pieces left or right randomly.
All right, we'll end with one final question, which is a rules question. Katie the Runt wants to know, what happens if you score your opposition's cargo?
If you score, if a red alliance, for example, scores blue cargo in the hub, blue gets the points.
That simple, huh? Okay, well, that is it from here on the field. We know you have a lot of brainstorming to do, a lot of building of robots to do, and a lot of strategizing in this game as well. So remember, read the manual. Thank you for joining us for the kickoffs. Thank you for attending a local kickoff, watching at home, watching at work. Have a great season. We are cleared for takeoff for Rapid React. Have a great season, everybody, and happy kickoff. Here we go.